Good day, student. Today we will learn the further topics of basic ICT kits. In this session, we will learn about computer system. So before starting computer system, first of all, we should know that what is computer. So what is computer? Computer is an automatic electronic calculating device which can process a given input in a prescribed manner to produce a desired output at a very high speed with remarkable accuracy. We get whatever the output we are receiving from the computer, we get the accurate answer, isn't it? And within a second, we get our output. There is some process of computer system, isn't it? What is the process of computer system? First one is input, then processing, then output. We give the input, user gives the input. In the CPU, the processing has been done as per our instructions, and those instructions are being converted into the desirable output at a remarkable accuracy. Okay, and we get within a second. But these three things has been performed in a computer. Okay, there are various parts of computer system. First is your input unit, next is memory unit, third one is central processing unit, and next one is your output unit. Okay, computer comprises of two parts. Okay, first one is your hardware, and second one is your software. What is software? What is hardware first? Hardware is the physical component, okay, which we can see and touch, like the cabinet of the computer case or everything inside it. Whatever the like your monitor is there, keyboard, mouse, printer, this all categories are come under what your hardware, which we can see as well as we can touch, and that are the physical components. Okay, next is your software. Software are what? Software refers to instructions of program that tell the hardware what to do. If we does not give any instructions to the hardware that this task to be performed, then hardware is just what? Hardware is just a machine without any life. Okay, so for inserting life, we have to give some instruction. For working, we have to give some instructions. So those instructions are being given through what? Through your software. Okay, next is your input unit. So in the input unit, there are two parts. Okay, the input instructions are given through this unit of the computer, like keyboard and through mouse. There are various other input units as well, like you have the scanner is also there. Okay, like you have microphone also there. These all are also the input unit. Okay, the standard input device is known as what? Your keyboard. Keyboard is used to provide the text-based input. Various combination of keys are used to issue specific commands to the computer. Okay, there are various keys, isn't it? Functions keys are there, shift keys there, enter key, alt key, control key, even numeric keys there, arrow keys there. Arrow keys used for giving the navigation, isn't it? So these are all the keys are the combination which gives some specific command to the computer. Next is your mouse. Mouse connected with the computer to interact with graphical user interface. From moving from one location to another, we use what? Your mouse. Okay, there is three buttons in mouse. First one is your left button, second one is your right button, and third one is a scroll. Okay, using scroll you can move from one page to another. Next is left button is there, next right button. So this all button have some specific conditions. Okay, left button is used to click and select the items with a single click. We double click, the programs are launched or files are opened. Okay, right button is used to display the common commands, like your personal windows there, control panel. Okay, personalization, we can get the right from the right button. We can get, if you want to get refresh, then also we can get from the right button the common command which we used to do in our system. Next is your central processing unit, the main unit of your system. The CPU is known as the brain of the computer. It is responsible for all the functions and processes. Whatever the input is giving, that task is being processed, and after processing, its duty is to give the desired output to the output unit. Okay, so see, you can see in the figure also, from the keyboard, mouse, other input unit, and this all input and units are going where? To your CPU. Okay, and then see, the data are being stored in your hard disk or the CD, in RAM. okay, in the memory it is being stored, and from there the desired output is going to the output unit. Those output unit could be the monitor, it could be the printer or speaker or other output unit it could be. Okay, the CPU comprises of two units. Okay, first one is ALU and second one is control unit. ALU is what? Arithmetic logic unit. And second is what here? Second is your control unit. So arithmetic logic unit, the arithmetic ALU performs all arithmetic operations such as addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. Even the logical operation like comparison between the two, this all operation are being performed under what? In our arithmetic logical unit. Next is your control unit. What do you mean by control unit? It coordinates the components of a computer system. In the control unit, as its name suggests, it is the circuitry that issues commands to other hardware component. This is used to control everything. All the programs and all the processes are being controlled under what unit? Under the control unit. What are the functions of CPU? See, the CPU accesses and stores the relevant data and instruction during the processing. Whatever the relevant data, whatever the important data, it is being all the data and instructions are being stored while processing. Next is your CPU. CPU controls the sequence of operation. The operation which has been given first will be operated first, and the second operation will be in the queue. Okay, as the first operation completed, then only the second operation will be operated. Okay, next is your CPU gives the commands and coordinate the action of all parts of the computer system. This gives us the command as well as it coordinate it, look everywhere whatever the actions are being going on. This it has the command for coordinating all the actions. Okay, CPU carries out the processing. Next is your storage unit. What do you mean by storage unit right now? Computers have two types of storage. First is your primary storage and second one is your secondary storage. Okay, so the CPU mainly interacts with primary storage or the main memory. Primary storage is known as what? Your main memory. And secondary storage is also known as what? Your auxiliary memory. Okay, so in the primary memory, both the memory we can give instructions and data, but the unit holds the data and instruction. There are different types of memory which are used for different purposes. So they, this has been categorized into two. That is, first one is primary memory, and under primary memory there are two, that is random access memory and read only memory. So primary memory is known as what? Your main memory. The memory is primarily used by CPU for booting up the system or running the system, and temporarily store the data for processing. In the primary memory, we store for temporary. Okay, where we store the temporary storage, in which part we store? In the RAM or row. RAM is what? Your random access memory. It is the main working memory of the computer. When we generally talk about a computer memory, we usually mean what? Your RAM. It is situated inside the system unit. You can see in the figure also that how the RAM looks and how the ROM looks. Okay, the CPU uses this memory for storing inputs, currently running software programs and results of processing, etc. It is also called read or write memory, as data can be able to read as well as write. Even it is known as what? Temporary or volatile memory. Means after switch on or switch off, the contents can be erased. In which memory? In the RAM. Okay, next is your ROM. ROM is a permanent or non-volatile memory. Means the content, if we switch off also the system, then also our content could not be removed. Okay, it contains a set of startup instructions called bootstrap loader. Means whatever at the time of instruction, some instructions has been given out that how it has to be worked. This instruction helps the computer to start up or boot up itself when you switch it on. Okay. Next is your secondary memory. Till now we have learned about primary memory. So in secondary memory is used for permanent storage. Whatever the data we are storing in permanent memory, the computer itself stores the data. But if you want to store for the further usage, and in that case you need some other memories for the storage, like you can store in the pen drives, hard disk, DVD. In this storage, the data could be stored for permanently, and for the later use we can use it. Next is your output unit. In the output unit, the result of the operation performed by the computer has been displayed. Okay, the computer generates the output in a desirable manner. It could be in the text form, graphics, audio, video, in any form it could be displayed through output unit. So what is the main output unit in our system? The first output unit, the basic output unit in our system is what here? Monitor. And the standard input device is what here? Keyboard. This thing you have to remember. The standard output unit is your monitor and the standard input unit is your keyboard. So the most common output devices are what? Your monitor and printer. Okay, how the printer could be the output devices? You give some instruction and we get the output through what? Printer, in through printing our pages. Okay, so printer also become what? Your output unit. So monitor is called the standard output devices, while other output devices like printer, web camera, joystick, plotter, speakers, this all are what? Your output unit. Next is peripheral devices. What do you mean by now peripheral devices? The basic devices from the actual computer system which perform standard input, output and processing operations. There are additional devices which extend the functionality of a computer system. For example, taking a printout, transferring data to another computer, distributing data, etc. Like USB, optical disk drives. These all are known as what are peripheral devices, which are not connected to the computer, but these are used while we are operating our computer system. These are the important things which we are using in our system. Like webcam is also there. These are also the web peripheral devices other than the main computer systems are known as what your peripheral devices. So in the optical disc can store information data like your video, audio, text, images, games, software. These are what optical disc. In the optical disc there are various types. First one is a CD-ROM. What is the abbreviation? Compact disc read only memory. So in this CD-ROM, it is an optical disc that comes with data already written on them for distribution. For example, like music, CDs, it is read only storage media, but data or information cannot be erased from it. Okay, in the pen drive also the data or information could not be erased till if the pen drive or CD has not been corrupted through the viruses. Okay, only if the system or the data has been corrupted through the virus, then only might be there is some chances to be erased. Okay, till then time your data will be saved and it will be permanently stored. Next, in the CD room there are further three types. First is your CDR. CDR is your compact disc recordable. Recordable. It is also called worm. Worm means what here? Right. Worm means not your biological terms worm. It is some other terms. What is worm? Write once, read many. Write once, read many. Means data can be written once but read many times. We can insert some data in our CD, but after that we could not erase it and insert once again. Okay, only one time only it could be inserted, data could be inserted, but we can read it, we can run our system many times. Okay, next is a CDRW. CDRW means what? Compact disc rewritable. It is rewritable disc. Okay, means it allows to erase previous data and write new data. If you have written in your data, the task has been fulfilled and you don't want to waste that particular CD, you just want to utilize once again, then what you will do? You will erase that particular data and you can reinsert the new data or instructions and you can run the particular CD. Okay. And your third type is a pen drive or USB drive. I think everyone is using right now pen drive and USB drive, isn't it? This is known as your USB. What is the full form of USB? USB is universal serial bus. Okay, so it is a flash memory device. It is used for storing and transferring the audio, video and data from one computer to another. It is very small in size. That's why it is portable, easy to carry and easy to use, as well as compared to other memories like RAM, ROM, this all memories, it is very low cost. Within a low cost, we can get this type of memory and we can store a lot of data in this memory. Okay, this is what your pen drive. Next is a digital card reader. Writer. Okay, so digital card readers are found in devices like laptops, digital cameras, and smartphones. Okay, these devices have slots to read from and write on the memory cards. You were using the memory cards, no? Those memory cards are known as what? Your digital card reader. You can use that memory card in your mobile as well as in your systems also. So next is your external hard disk. External hard disk means what? In addition to computer's main storage device, hard disk, there are external hard disks available. This they can be easily connected with computer through USB port. Using the USB port only, we can connect what? Your external hard disk. The external hard disk is best suited devices for keeping backup of the computer data, since it can store data into range of 500 MB to 2 TB or even more in near future. Means if your system, if your hard disk has been fulfilled, so how, what you will do, in the small memory devices it can store up to 2 GB, 8 GB, 16 GB or 32 GB, but to store more than that, either the option is there to carry 5 to 6 pen drives, but there is some loss in data. So it is better to have the external hard disk because it can carry more, in the large number we can store our data and informations. Okay, and next is a USB based adapter. What is adapter? Adapter allows devices running on different types of technology to connect with a computer. So what are the basic adapters we are using right now? Like Bluetooth wireless speaker is there. So for that we need some adapter, okay, to connect through Bluetooth and speaker. Okay, next is smartphones connect with computer. Wi-Fi adapter connects Wi-Fi modem to the computer. And then next is your printer, scanner and plotter. So what is printer? Printer, it prints out the hard copy of the document and images over variety of medium, like paper is there, plastic sheets, etc., ranging from the simple desktop printer to industry. In the line printer used to print banners and posters, printers come in wide variety to cater to various printing needs of various industries. There are various type of printers also available. First is dot matrix printer. Dot matrix printer prints using the dot. Okay, printer works by striking a grid of pins against a ribbon. Using the dots, we could be able to print our data. Okay, in a sheet of paper, it prints the character in dotted format. You can see here how it looks. You can also see here. Okay, basically the dot matrix printer example you can see in the railway stations. Okay, in the railway station counter, the printer which is available, no, they are using the dot matrix printer. Next is your inkjet printer. Inkjet printer is a kind of printer that works by spraying ionized ink. By spraying the ionized ink, we can print the line of data, okay, on a sheet of paper or magnetized placed in the ink's path, direct the ink in onto the paper in the desired shapes to create the impression of text or images. Next is your laser printer. It is the latest technology printer which prints the character by laser beam. It has a drum which works with the help of laser beam. So dot matrix printer using the dot, inkjet printer using the ionized ink, spraying the ionized ink, and laser printer using the technology of laser. Next is your plotter. So what do you mean by plotter? Plotter draw or plot building maps or project designs. Okay, these are used by architects and project designer to print in a high quality or in a big size. We use what? Your plotters. They were used in applications such as computer aided designs, example engineering and architectural drawing. These plotters are being used. Okay, next is your scanner. What do you mean by scanner? These devices are used to scan the documents and store them in a computer for later use. The flatbed scanner can scan whole sheets of document, while handheld scanners are useful for quick scanning of a part of document, like a few lines or an image. Next is your web camera. Web camera captures the live video stream and still images. In the laptop, the web camera has been inserted. Okay, but in the like your PCs is available. So in PC, what happens? You have to connect the web camera. Okay, so for that we use what? web camera. Expansion cards. What do you mean by expansion cards? Are the additional circuit boards that provide extended functionality to the computer, like enhanced sound, high quality video rendering, or connecting the computer to a particular network. They are called expansion cards. Since they expand the functionality of computer beyond its basic features, expansion cards can be easily inserted in the corresponding expansion slots available on the motherboard inside the CPU. If you want to expand your additional circuit, okay, then you use what? Expansion cards. Other digital devices like speaker is there, joystick. Speaker is used to, you know, to generate the sounds. Joystick is a pointing device. Basically, we use these devices for playing games. Okay. Now, session 3, basic computer operation. First, we'll see how the computer works, how we can switch a computer system on. Basically, you all know it, but then also we'll revise that how to switch on your system, isn't it? Usually, computer system connected with main through a UPS. What is the full form of UPS? Uninterrupted power supply. I'm repeating, uninterrupted power supply is the full form of UPS. Okay, the steps to switch on the computer are as follows. Switch on the UPS by a long press on its power button, then press the power button on the CPU cabinet and or the system unit, and as the system you press the power button, the internal booting system will be on and you can see the CPU is switched on. Okay, next is computer software. So what is computer software? In the previous topic also, where the software has been came, I have said that it uses hardware. It gives some instructions to the hardware to run our system. Okay, without the software, the power of hardware is of no use. So it is the software that helps performing various tasks of by making use of hardware. Software and hardware complement each other and together make the complete computer system. So for that, the operating system is very important in our computer. Okay, without operating system, the computer could not even run. Okay, so operating system controls the entire functionality of the computer system. The operating system allows the user to interface with the computer hardware and make use of other software applications on the computer. The modern operating system provides a user-friendly or easy to use and use graphical user interface, GUI. GUI means what? Which allows the user to use mouse point and click at the command to be given to the computer, or the graphical things also we can see through what your GUI. Okay, there are various functions of operating system. Hardware management, we could be able to manage our hardware. Next is software management. All software are being managed through the operating system. Without the operating system, a single software, a single game or single application could not be able to run. Next is data and storage management. All the data and stored management are being operated through what your operating system itself. And third one is a user interface. User interface could be type of any, like it could be of GUI or any other type. Okay. There are various other functionalities of operating system as well. Apart from above mentioned core function like data management, software management, hardware management, there are many other functions as well. Like first one is security. All the modern operating system come with certain built-in security features. Though you don't put in the system your antivirus, then also it has some inbuilt security features that makes our desktop or operating system secure through our password-based user access or basic firewall. Next is your system utilities. What are system utilities? There are a set of software utilities to ensure adequate health of computer and its smooth functioning. Some of the main utilities are backup, restore, and that helps take backup or our data or on an external storage devices and restore it in the case of data losses. Okay, next is entertainment. Operating system provide a small set of inbuilt games. Okay, some inbuilt games are there. Okay, solitaire is there, hearts in Windows is there. Some of games are inbuilt in the for the purpose of what? In entertainment. Next is basic accessories. There are various inbuilt small programs to do in basic small things like your calculator is there, audio recording, screen recording, text editing. These are the small accessories which are being used. There are various types of operating system. First is single operating system. Such operating system only allow one user at a time. We can use only one user like DOS, Windows 95. Next is multi-user. Multi-user means we can user can do task 2 to 3 at a time. Like Windows 7, Windows 10, Linux, Unix. In this operating system, we can perform 2 to 3 operations at a time. So this is known as what? Multi-user operating system. This is command line user interface. What is command line user interface? Such operating system provide a command line on which user can type commands to accomplish tasks on the computer system. Example, DOS, Unix, the black screen is coming out now. In that, we are writing what your command line. Okay, is to give some proper instruction or commands to the system for performing the specific task. Okay. Next is a graphical user interface operating system. The operating system provides an interface composed of graphical menus like buttons, taskbar, dialog boxes. Like I can give you the example of your simple desktop. In this, you have many taskbar is there, buttons is there. So that is known as your graphical user interface, which operate using some graphics or help of mouse. We can interpret our instructions from one place to another. Next is a mobile operating system. A mobile operating system, also referred to as a mobile operating system, an operating system that operates a smartphones, tablet, or other mobile devices. The most popular operating system is your like Apple iOS is there, Google's Android is there, Dreams is there, BlackBerry operating system. This all are what your mobile operating system. These are application software. There are various application software. First one is operating system and operating system, then application software. For application software, there are various type of application software like MS Office is there, Adobe Photoshop, Oracle, for database management system. So these software applications are used to perform various tasks in variety of fields. Like MS Office suits are used in small businesses for creating the documents, spreadsheets, publishing, email. This image processing and illustration software are known as what your Adobe Photoshop. This software are small software, but has the work in their particular fields. Okay. Next is graphical user interface. The modern operating system provides a very rich set of graphical components combined together into interface, which user can interact with by help of mouse and keyboard shortcuts. This interface or operating system called what? Graphical user interface. Okay. Now, the daily component which we are using in our system is what your file. What do you mean by file? Every time we say that we are saving our document in our file. So what is file right now? The file is a collection of related information. In other words, a file is a collection of data stored on a storage devices. There are different types of file depending on the type of information they contain. Like document file is there, image file is there, music file. It depends on you that how you are making your file comprises of. So looks at the figure and notice that every file is following two parts. Okay, first one is primary name. It is the first name of file. It can be of any name given by the user. Next is secondary name. It is the extension of file. Like what is that particular file type? Like I have said, picture. So picture is the file is of which type? Picture file. Okay, so the extension will be .jpg. So the name comprises of the primary name and .jpg is comprises of the secondary name, which is known as the extension of file. Okay, next is a folder. A folder is a place where many files are stored. In other words, the files are contained in a folder. A folder is also known as what your directory. A collection of related files can be stored in a common folder. A folder can also contain different folders or files in them. Next, icon. The small pictures on the screen are known as what your icon. Taskbar. The small information bar which is displayed in the down of your desktop, in where all the information are being stored in the horizontal bar and mode, is what your taskbar. Start button. Start button is found on the left side of the taskbar. Okay, by using start button, menu appears, which is known as start menu. Okay, you can find and open all the programs through what your start menu. Next is quick launch toolbar. The quick launch toolbar provides an easy access. It is also available in the bottom side of your desktop. Okay, these programs can be opened in one click. Next is your middle section. The middle section shows us the program and files we have opened and allow us to quickly switch between them. Next is your system tray. In the system tray is used to show the date and time and various other notification. Okay, when we left click on the start button, the start menu appears. It contains the list of programs which are installed in the program. So put the mouse cursor on the start button and left click on it. The start menu appears. On the right side of menu, left side, left click on the computer option. The computer window appears on the screen, and you can see the computer display is being opened. Okay, shutting down the computer. How could you be able to shut down your computer? Click on the start button, and in the start menu, click on the shutdown. My computer. The my computer comprises all the folders and drives available in your computer. It could be of C drive, A to Z drive. You can open it. Okay, recycle bin. In the recycle bin, anything which has been deleted first comes to recycle bin. And if you feel like any folder has been deleted by you, accidentally, so you can restore it through your recycle bin. Okay, next, my network places of network. It shows all the computer over the local network which might be connected by your computer. Next one is my documents or documents. It is the default folder to contain most of your work. Okay, next part is your taskbar and start menu. Using the taskbar and start menu, you could be able to see whatever the taskbar, whatever you have to display the icons of active and minimized programs. Okay, these are shown in in your taskbar. Some useful folders that are available in start menu are it helps and support to provide the document form or basic help. Even we can be able to search any program or file by its name. We can set or customize the various systems. Okay, these all things can be done in our start menu. Next is your Windows accessories. How you can get the Windows accessories? There are various type of Windows accessories, like your calculator, notepad is there, paint, wordpad is there. You just need to click on start, then all programs, and then accessories. You can get every type of accessories available. Calculator is used to calculate by using their various number keys, isn't it? Paint is used to teach students how to draw the pictures on the screen and paint. Okay, you can use this program for creating, editing, and printing images. Okay, next is your WordPad. The WordPad is a basic word processor. The more advanced of WordPad is a Notepad. Okay, where you can create, edit, view, and print the text document. Now the next session, performing basic file operation. There are basic file operations. Okay, how to operate our basic files. Okay, in the files and folder, like all reports can be kept in the report folder, which has further subfolder by the names of years or months. So how to operate those files operation. First, see Windows Explorer. Windows operating system provide a user friendly interface to work with files and folders, isn't it? Left side navigation pane is there, right side navigation pane is there, tree. In the left side navigation tree, it displays the structure tree of drives and folder on your computer. In right side, it lists the contents of the drive or folder selected in the navigation panel. You can clearly see in this picture also that how the navigation is being allotted. Okay, by using the search option also, you can see you can find your files and folders. Okay, in the address bar, the location where the files and folder is being stored, it has been shown. Okay, these are the drives available. Okay, next is left pane. In the left pane, you can see that what are the minimized file are being opened, or under the file what all files are available. In the left pane, you can be able to see. Okay, Windows Explorer allows what all things. It could be able to create and create files and folder, locate open files, move copy files and folder, delete files and formatted disk partitions, access other storage media. It by using this, we can store files in default location for pictures, video, music. We could be able to access, share data on other computer, arrange contents into various layouts like list, small icons, etc. Isn't it? Next is computer file and folder. As I have said earlier, also file is what it is, an object of a computer system that store data, information, settings, or command of a computer system. If you store many another types of format like image file, document file, so they here it has some extensions also. Like you can see the secondary name available for document .txt, .doc, .rtf, .pdf. This all are the extension. .pdf is for Adobe, like PDF format we use. What .pdf. For documentation, .docx. For text file, we use .txt. Spreadsheet, for Excel file, we use .xls. For open office calculation spreadsheet, we use .sxc. Images, .gif, .jpg, .png. Next, executable program and script. .exe, .com, .pat. These all are the extensions which are available for saving our different types of file. Folder is a place where a location of file or data are stored. Number of files you can store in where? In your folder. Okay. Basic file and folder operation. How you could be able to operate your file? Creating new folder. How could you create a new folder? You just need to click open the computer, then you will click on new, right click on the blank area, and then you will find a new option. A sub menu appears, click on the folder option. You can create it, and even you can press it and rename the folder according to our name, and your new folder is what? Created. Okay. Rename file or folder. By chance, if you have named your folder as wrong, so you can be able to rename. Just you need to go to your particular file, then you need to right click that particular file, and you will find the rename option over there. See here, rename option is there. Then you just need to click on the rename, and you can type whatever the particular name you just suggested, and then press enter key. Okay, then you will find that your file has been renamed. A delete file, simply you just click on the file or the folder which you need to delete, and then you just need to click on the delete button. Okay, the particular file will be deleted. Or second option is that you just need to go to right click, and in the right click panel you will find the delete option. You just need to click on delete, and the option and the file or folder will be deleted, and it will be first moved into the recycled bin. From there, if you feel like you have done accidentally, then you can restore your file or folder. Okay. Next is copy file or folder. How you could be able to copy your file or folder? Like you what is copy and what is cut? These are the two basic operations. Copy means what? By chance, the data will be available in the original location as well as in the new location. But while you are cutting and pasting, what happens? The data which is available in original location will be moved to the new location. It will no longer be available in your original location. It will only available in your new location. This is what a cut. So how you could be able to copy and cut or paste? You just need to locate and select the file, then right button, and do the copy. The shortcut is Ctrl plus C. Also you can do, then you just need to change the drive or folder where the target location will be, and just you need to do what? Ctrl plus V to paste, or right click and you will get the option of paste, and then just click on paste, the option will be pasted. Okay, next is moving file. Same method, just need to select the file or folder, then go to the targeted location where you want to say paste your content, and then just Ctrl plus V or right click, and then you will find what your paste option, and then you can paste your file. Okay. Selecting file in sequence. What do you mean by selecting files in sequence? Just what you have to do, you just need to click left click and select all the files what are to be selected, from the left, from the top to the bottom. Then your file could be selected in a sequence. But in a non-continuous file, like you just need to cut, click on control, and just need to select what all files you have to select, like first file, third file, seventh file. This you can select by using control key. Okay, so for this session, this much only. We'll meet on the next. Thank you.